this new relationship that we upgraded with Deadpool and Colossus is something that I'm really proud of, because, you know, me and Ryan, we worked really, you know, closely on this, and, you know, we brought some new, how to say that, some sort of like upgrade of Colossus in this like brotherly father figure kind of. And then again, you know, it's much bigger role than in the first one on the other side. And the most beautiful thing for me as a comic book geek is that I had a chance to fight Juggernaut. And, you know, to say the line, pick on someone your own size, you know, that's the thing. When you're like comic book geek, that's one of the lines. You're like, you're just saying it. It's beautiful. But getting into real fight, it's amazing. In the first part, I mainly did like ADR, you know, just giving the voice and a little bit of CGI. In this one, I had like, of course, help from a stunt double who did like a great job on the set, but then I had to get into the costume and do all the facial expressions. So I did like mainly the everything that's regarding acting and the facial expressions and the CGI later in the studio with David and Ryan. So it was tough because I did like, you know, simultaneously I did CGI and, you know, voice and everything else. So it was something really new for me, but the result is beautiful, so I'm really proud and happy. All the things that are funny, as you said before, they are in the movie, you know, so you like have so much great things going on. Like in the first part, I love to make, you know, Tim Miller, the director on the first one, to make him, he cannot stand by you when he's when you're like doing a puke, which I had like in the first one, like doing, you know, like, you know, then he just, you know, he just needs to leave the room, you know. So whenever I was, you know, I wanted something to experiment, then I would do that. So he would leave the room. on the sequel, well, the funniest thing was like trying to find the F word, you know, between me and Ryan. So we did like so many different ways of trying to, you know, how would Colossus torture himself to say the fuck, you know. So we did like hundreds of different versions. In the end, this one is that we picked up. But, you know, there's just so many amazing little things that are going on while you're filming. So, and you have like amazing movie, huge franchise. The first one was a phenomenon. So, you know, you're coming to the sequel, working the sequel with, you know, the thing before. So everybody's so happy and people are really connected as a family. So, you know, it's really beautiful thing to do.
What would you use Colossus's voice for next?
For next? Well, that's a tough question. Mind the gap.
Can you expect a Deadpool 3?
We have extremely successful franchise, so there is like, you know, rumors about X-Force, Deadpool 3, so we'll see what's gonna happen. Just wait, and we are not allowed to say anything. I'm waiting for Colossus to meet his sister Ileana Magique, and New Mutants are coming next year, so yeah, I'm hoping, you know, you'll have Rasputin's back, you know, together in a movie. So we'll see what's going to happen, but I'm really counting on that, you know. That will be really fantastic to see. We don't know what's going to happen, but, you know, that was such a successful franchise, so whoever takes it over, I don't think they're going to change anything, and I don't want that to be changed, because, you know, Deadpool is Deadpool. It needs to stay R-rated, you know, X-Force 2. So it's. I don't think it's going to be anything. You know, you don't want to destroy something that's, like, making so much money. And first of all, you need to satisfy fans. So if they make that mistake, they're going to have to fight dirty. You know, the first issue, the first appearance of Colossus in 1975, it was giant-sized X-Men by Dave Cockrum and Len Wein. Unfortunately, they're not alive anymore, but the thing is, I even like got that issue, I bought it like a few months ago with signatures of both of them. So always when you ask me about, like, my favorite is the beginning, the first appearance of Storm, Colossus, and Nightcrawler. And then that whole series with Chris Claremont as the writer, who is like absolute god, and, you know, the art of the other one. It's just that whole show, and I love when Colossus becomes a proletarian. If you remember that, when he gets kind of evil, and then again when he becomes unstoppable, Colossus as you know, with Juggernaut's power. So we can talk about it like for all day long if you want. No problem with that.
There's always been this great relationship between Wolverine and Deadpool.
Fastball special.
Do you think that's something we're ever going to get to see on screen? Obviously, I mean, Hugh's leaving the role, but then the character's kind of free now. He's not.
You cannot, like, X-Men without Wolverine, or, like, you know, Fastball Special without Wolverine, just because it doesn't work. So, and Wolverine is one of, like, the most loved characters of all time, and Hugh Jackman did amazing, amazing job, and I feel kind of bad that he doesn't want to play it anymore. Well, he did it for so long. I'm not sure who would be, like, the perfect Wolverine now after him, and, you know, I thought that maybe Tom Hardy would be, but now he's Venom, so... There are like some choices, but we'll see what's going to happen in the future. Well, I want to see Colossus go directly against the Justice League by himself. Yeah. No. Well, I don't want to lie. My first love was always DC. Was DC in the beginning? You know, Superman, Batman, Wonder Woman. So I started with those characters, and then I got into Marvel. So Marvel is my second love in a way, but I. Stayed faithful to them till today, but then again I love to watch all the things that and to read DC comics, because I think the comics are much better than the movies, unfortunately for them. But yes, it's I would go against, if I need to choose, for me Joker is maybe the best villain of all time, and you know it would be interesting to see, you know, how Joker would like go against Colossus, and so it's that would be a beautiful thing. There is like one comic book in which you have Marvel versus DC. Yeah. I have that one, and it's really beautiful. And the good thing is that Ryan is one of the writers in Deadpool 2, by the way. Yeah. So you always have Rhett and Paul with him, the other two writers, and you know, so you do the things that are already in the script, but then you have this time in which you just improvise with them, and they're like, you know, feeding you with lines or ideas, so then you can experiment and you can improvise. A lot of those things just disappear later, but a lot of things come into the movie. So it's just a beautiful project when you have writers and Ryan with you, and those guys are so fast and so funny. So it's a beautiful process in so many ways.
Your experience very different from the other people on set, you feel?
Sorry?
Do you feel like your experience is very different from the other people on set, since it's not like
Well, yes, as a matter of fact, because this is for me. It was really difficult in the beginning because I'm not used to doing like the CGI and the voice all simultaneously at the same time and doing like all the scenes. But in the end, it comes back to the same thing as everybody else, you know, because you're just like doing. It's not just ADR and you're like feeding the lines. You just need to like do all the scenes which are already filmed or are filming. So, you know, but the beauty is that you're creating that CGI character in so many ways. So it's a new thing that I know now, and I'm really proud of that. For me, definitely, you know, trying to make Colossus swear and say, so, you know, just because Colossus doesn't swear, so this was like a specific scene in which we tried. Ryan was having like so many ideas. Should we go with like, you know, him struggling and, you know, doing that? So we did like hundreds of F words in so many ways and so much struggles. And that was like the weirdest thing, like trying to just say one word. But because Colossus is not a person that would do that, except that, you know, it's a dying wish of his friend. So it sounds weird, but it was a beautiful process trying to do that. Yeah, it really was. Even having Brad Pitt for like 3 seconds as a Punisher, yeah. Come on. That's so beautiful. The twist with them is amazing. And then in the end, thanks to her, and she's, well, Negasonic makes that time machine. Yeah, she fixed it. So Deadpool saves Peter, which is a beautiful thing on the other side too. Yeah. Yeah, I'm going to be in the fourth season of Better Call Saul. And yeah, that's coming out in August. I cannot say much about it. Then again, I have a show that's coming on Netflix, which was produced by Tim Miller, and that's coming like later this year. So you're gonna see a lot of me in the future. And we'll see what's gonna happen with the Deadpool and X-Force franchises. And yeah, but for now, this is it. Yeah.